And welcome back to Let's Play Mass Effect 2. Not 3, not 1, but 2. Blind. Base hamster. Feed the fishies. Cool. So, last episode, we rescued from his tank the...
No messages for you, Commander.
Thank you, Kelly. The Krogan, who has decided to name himself Grunt. I'm gonna explore more of this nebula that we're in. Okay, so we got all this... I don't think we need any fuel, right? Just came here from a mass relay. Now let's get some probes. Let's go to Relic. Oh my, there's quite a lot here. Yeah, Relic. There we go. I'm like, where's the button? Cool. Planets. Stuff to explore. Let's start with the outermost planet. This one here. Beach Thunder. Wow. Beach Thunder lives and dies on the price of titanium, the metal being the only reason to come to this frozen rock. A best-selling e-novel, The Hard Stuff, has popularized the story of the miners on the planet. It allows the Hanor and Drell robo-miners competing with Krogan and Vorcha, who simply put on environment suits and lays the titanium out more or less by hand. As the novel's promotional screed says, accidents are frequent, rivalry is fierce, and vengeance served up fast. Interesting. Gravity is about twice that of Earth. It's very cold there. Let's scan, see what we've got. Because we do need titanium, I think it said it was, right? Yeah. We need a lot of that. Oh, not titanium. Platinum? Hold on a second. Titanium, oh. Well, we don't need titanium for what we're doing. I got confused with platinum, I think. Let's see what else we might need. Well, fine. I'm not looking for iridium at this time. I'm gonna save our probes for the other elements. Hell yeah, look at that.
Probe launched.
Significant increase there. Let's get one for iridium.
Probe launched.
We can always get more probes. We just have so much iridium. I can only go this way. Oh. Yeah, look at that.
Probe away.
Alright, good. Oh, how pretty. Praying Mouth. What the name? The names of these planets are very interesting. It's almost like some kind of American Indian names, maybe. A hydrogen helium gas giant, Praying Mouth is a ship-killing enigma, the Bermuda Triangle of the Terminus systems. There are many theories why ships never returned from there. undetectable space debris, old disruptor torpedoes, and magnetic mines from a long-forgotten war, even miniature black holes, but what is clear is that too many ships have been lost there for it to be happenstance. Travel advisory. Due to the large number of ships lost when attempting to discharge their drive cores in Praying Mouth, the Relic system highly recommends using First Land's complementary discharge stations instead. Not gonna get sucked in, are we? Oh, there's some Element Zero here.
Launching probe.
We hardly ever find Element Zero. We find some more. Oh yeah, look at that.
Probe launched.
Keep up this, we're gonna be able to research some more stuff. Yeah, a little bit of palladium. Here we go.
Probe away.
Ezo, baby! Ezo and platinum.
Probe away.
Now, it may be moderate, but this place is great because I have barely found any Element Zero anywhere. There's some more platinum.
Probe launched.
Iridium, I'm gonna skip that. Okay. Oh, look at this tiny thing! You are small, Rough Tide. A dwarf planet with a shroud of carbon monoxide and dioxide that keeps it warm, Rough Tide was so named when large veins of platinum and palladium were struck and miners from all over the cluster came in to stake their claims. Hanar police and their Drell enforcers clashed with Krogan and Vorcha in an ugly series of race riots in the late 2170s, and the planet has only grudgingly kept a shaky peace since then. Well, let's see if we can find any palladium or platinum left over from these raids. Rich, nice. Iridium. Look at that.
Launching probe.
Can we just look at it? Just look at that. I want more.
Probe away.
Freaking awesome.
Launching probe.
Platinum.
Launching probe.
Palladium.
Launching probe.
Well, that one sounded weird. Oh, look at all that platinum.
Probe away.
We need that for our stuff, our ship stuff and other things. Our research. Should I go for this one? Oh wait, it went- oof! Oof!
Probe away.
You can now afford the Krogan Shotgun Research Project. Cool. little more palladium, maybe? Eh. Half my probes are gone. I'm gonna stop here for now. So nothing's orbiting with this asteroids, I guess. Let's check out this planet. There's a whole bunch. Fourth from the sun. Island Wind. A large hydrogen-nitrogen gas giant, Island Wind is named for the sweet-smelling land breezes that come off the archipelagos of Kaji in the evening. As tumultuous as any other Jovian giant, Island Wind has cyclones that span tens of thousands of kilometers. Moderate. Come on, you gotta get me better than that. You can find a little bit of everything at one point, but not a lot at one time. Then I'll go for this palladium.
Probe launched.
Platinum.
Probe launched.
Skipping the iridium. Just have so much of it. Done. I like the names of these planets, they're pretty cool. First Land. A hydrogen helium gas giant believed to be an extrasolar capture, First Land is home to many space stations supporting the ubiquitous refueling platforms. A thriving community of Drell and Hanra make their homes in orbit here, giving the solar system's robo-miners somewhere to go when the 50-hour days and nights are driving them mad. Moderate here. Iridium. Here we go. Palladium.
Probe away.
Go for some iridium and platinum.
Probe away.
More palladium.
Probe launched.
Iridium. I think I've come full circle here. I am satisfied here. Second from the sun. Fitful Current. Fitful Current was so named because it orbits in retrograde, indicating that it may have been an extrasolar planet that was captured by the Relic system's gravity well. Large for a rock planet, Fitful Current has only traces of hydrogen in its extremely thin atmosphere. Hanor robo-miners have recovered some uranium and thorium deposits from its depths. This is another possible extrasolar planet. Rich? Oh, nice. I want better than that. That's pretty good.
Probe launched.
Palladium time. Skipping iridium. Here we go, platinum.
Launching probe.
What we really need the most are platinum and also element zero, which we hardly ever find. A lot of iridium here. Done. It's pretty freaking rich in iridium, and unfortunately we don't need iridium. And here, this little tiny planet, so close to the sun. murky water. Despite the name, murky water has yet to show any signs of having water whatsoever. Its name is a literal translation from the original Hanar, who considered murky water a sign of danger. Murky water has a hazy, crushing atmosphere of carbon dioxide and methane, which brings the surface heat to boiling levels. It remains unexploited, its gravity and temperature too high to bother. Well, we get the spoils from that, because it's a rich planet in stuff. Hopefully in more than just iridium. Right, here we go, some platinum.
Probe launched.
I think platinum is either 25,000 or 30,000 we need. Oh, nice. Look how high that goes.
Probe away.
Nice.
Probe launched.
There's like 3,000 or so platinum. This is our last planet, might as well go for broke.
Launching probe.
Cause after this I'm gonna go back and get some more look at that. Some more probes.
Launching probe.
I've mined it down to good. I'm gonna use up the rest of the probes, get some iridium, why the hell not?
Probe away. Launching probe.
Here we go.
Probe launched.
Done. Well, this is cool. Head back to Emir. Fuel up. Head to the next system. Malgus, I guess. Go to Malgus. We have one more. How many more? Two more? Strabo and Amun next. This is a small system. Got this one here. Flet. Uninhabitable by most species, Flet is home to the Blood Pack's vulture training and breeding grounds. The thick atmosphere is nearly all nitrogen and lacks oxygen, which poses no hazard to the vulture. Needing little but imports of food and water, vulture mercenaries and mercenaries to be train religiously to overpower and kill whoever the company is at war with this time. Travel advisory. Flet's spaceports are wholly owned subsidiaries of the Blood Pack Mercenary Company, a corporation undergoing numerous criminal investigations for capital crimes. Civilian traffic to Flet is strongly discouraged. Hey, this is rich in resources. Right away, iridium. Some palladium.
Launching probe.
I'm gonna stop mining for palladium also. We really need platinum and element zero. There you go.
Probe launched.
Evidently it's 30,000 platinum we need for some stuff.
Launching probe.
No? Rill. A planet only a Vorcha could love, Rill is notable for its near-miss climate, punishing heat and a thin, toxic methane-ethane atmosphere. Its surface is dotted with Krogan and Vorcha habitats, eking out a meager living off the planet's tin and copper deposits, and killing anyone who cuts into their profits. Travel advisory. Krogan can survive in the heat without the use of a breath mask. All other species require environmental suits to avoid heat exhaustion and burns. Liquid water can be found in large lakes on the surface. This can be used for thermoregulation, but it is not potable without processing. Alliance Bulletin. Large-scale gang warfare is a regular occurrence on Rill. Civilian travel is not advised. I wish we could land on these planets and, like, explore and stuff. It looks pretty cool, though. It looks like a marble, like a big, like, tannish, pinkish bowling ball with little holes to stick your fingers in. But yeah, we can't land on any of this stuff. Rich, nice. That's a lot of platinum and palladium. I'm going for it.
Probe launched.
No, I think we needed 50,000 platinum for stuff. Look at that much. I can't resist.
Probe away.
It's just so much right there. And there.
Probe away.
Got a lot of palladium.
Launching probe.
Hell yeah, platinum. And palladium.
Launching probe.
I balanced that out because we really need the platinum. And done. One more planet. Uzin. Named for one of many Krogan gods of vengeance, Uzin is a gas giant close enough to its orange sun that none of its moons are considered habitable. Its composition is largely hydrogen and methane, with traces of xenon that the Krogan collect for use in ion drives. Uzin is well within the frost line where gas giants usually do not form, leading astronomers to believe that its orbit used to be farther from the star. If so, this would indicate a seriously unstable orbit, and the planet may plunge into its star within a few million years. Wow. Moderate. Look at all the red. Is that? I don't remember that. Yeah, I don't really need palladium and iridium. Well, it's really good like this, though. I just
probe
go for
away.
It. All right, that's it for that one. Done with another system. Only 25 minutes in, so I'm gonna go to another one. Let's go refuel at the mass relay, of course, first. shot my mark. Let's go to Amun, or Amun. Only Strabo next? Yeah. Alright, let's check out... Where is this one? Bast. A small hydrogen-nitrogen gas giant, Bast and its moons served as the Eclipse Mercenary Company's fallback position after their defeat on Neath. Once they had gathered their strength, they leaked a false position to the Nahezit Consortium to lure them into a trap, which devolved into a pitched battle. Both sides claimed victory. Nahezit lost more ships, but could afford the setback in a way Eclipse could not. How about a little of everything here? Except for Element Zero.
Probe launched.
I know why they call it Element Zero, so you can find it 0% of the time. Almost. Platinum.
Probe launched. Probe away.
More palladium.
Detected.
Ooh, anomaly detected on Neath. Cold and dry, Neath has a thin nitrogen atmosphere and a vast salt flats at its equator, which is warm enough for liquid water to pool during the summer period. The revealed salt is collected and sold to sodium-poor planets for agricultural purposes. During the Anher rebellions, Neath was a staging ground for Eclipse ships and was the site of their last defeat, when enemy Nahezit surprised and routed them with a superior force. Some wreckage from the battle can still be found on the planet today. Now we are rich and we have anomaly. What's it saying? All that palladium.
Probe away. Probe launched.
It's around this way. Some kind of transmission, I guess? Beacon something. Status of system operator is not known. General distress.
Translation error. Status of system operator is not known. General distress. Beacon process interrupted. Translation error. Status of system operator is not known. General distress. Beacon process interrupted. Translation error. Status of system operator is not known.
Probe launched.
I'm gonna actually save that. I'm not gonna go there yet.
Probe launched.
I want to finish exploring the...
Probe away.
The system. Okay, we will go to Neith soon.
Anomaly detected.
I know. I don't want to forget these other planets, so I'm going to look at them first. Anher. A garden world with heavy populations of humans and Batarians, Anher was home to one of the ugliest violations of sapient rights in modern human history. A consortium of corporations and corrupt politicians, fearing Batarian economic competition due to their custom of legal slavery, passed a resolution that abolished the minimum wage, effectively relegalizing slavery on a human-dominated world. Opponents of the motion quickly turned to activism and violence. A civil war erupted as one side fought to end slavery throughout the system, and another, primarily Batarian faction called the Nehezit, sought to keep the slaves they had. The Anher rebellions raged from 2176 to 2178. The Nehezit had a significant advantage in ships, labor, and weapons, forcing the Anher militias to hire mercenary companies to even the odds. In the end, the abolitionists won out, though at the cost of much of their infrastructure. Though Anher today still has significant natural wealth, it is economically depressed, save for the reconstruction industry. Population 208,587,000. Colony founded in 2165. Capital New Thebes? I'll say that. Orbital period twice that of Earth. A day is 18 hours. It's pretty cold there. And surface gravity is slightly above that of Earth. And right away, platinum. A lot.
Launching probe.
Just gonna remember to save one probe for that anomaly.
Launching probe.
Did I see element zero? A little. Look at that.
Probe away.
5,000 we need, yes. You can now afford the Advanced Training Research Project. Yay! Look, there's more here.
Probe launched.
Not too easy to find element zero. Platinum.
Probe away.
Oh, look at that. Oh, nice. That is an awesome find right there.
Probe away.
Cool, platinum.
Probe launched.
This is an awesome planet. Look at that. More ESO.
Probe away.
I love this place! Palladium and some element zero.
Launching probe.
Alright, I'm good. One more planet. Actually, two more. See that one almost. Sobek. A hydrogen-nitrogen gas giant believed to be an extrasolar capture, Sobek's low-G moons were the site of many Batarian labor camps during the Anher rebellions, generating raw materials for the war. When the slaves are finally liberated by Eclipse, the mercenaries found abysmal conditions, including whole camps that lacked mass effect fields to keep the gravity at habitable levels. The widespread bone loss among the slaves were part of their master's final degradation. It would cripple them if they ever left for a standard gravity world. The plight of the slaves soon garnered galactic media attention, and several charities sprung up to pay for their physical therapy and find them gainful employment. Eclipse, normally reviled for their cutthroat tactics and criminal employees, found themselves painted as heroes. The mercenary company still retains an office on Sobek's moon, Heket, out of nostalgia as much as a business strategy. Sorry. Moderate. Some iridium. I'm not gonna bother with the palladium at this point. I know how to launch a probe game. Don't you know how many of these planets I've done so far? Platinum. Need 50,000. 50,000, baby! Keep going! Damn it. Iridium. Platinum, baby.
Probe away.
Probably should get over it. Damn it. So close. Maybe we'll find more on this other planet. Sekhmet. A hydrogen-helium gas giant believed to have entered Amun's system within the last billion years. Sekhmet was the site of an important battle in the Anhur Rebellions. When the Eclipse Mercenary Company sought to capture the refueling stations to deny the rebels' supplies, a fighter wing hiding in Sekhmet's rings ambushed them. Eclipse suffered heavy initial losses, but destroyed two rebel carriers and forced them to retreat into FTL. This was considered the high water mark of the rebellion. At no point after the Battle of Sekhmet did the rebels have a victory. Today, Sekhmet is home to refueling stations and a small war memorial in orbit at the planet's L5 Lagrange point. Days are very short. Moderate. Platinum, baby. At this point, I'll take a small amount of platinum just to get us over that 50,000 mark. Some element zero, though.
Launching probe.
Nice. Element zero.
Probe away.
Some platinum here. There we go.
Probe away.
What do we get? You can now afford the med bay upgrade research project. Yay! Some probes left. Now there's another thing where we need another 50,000, so we gotta keep going. Unfortunately, I'm done with this planet. Now, Neith. Next episode, guys. We'll examine the anomaly on Neith. See what's there. And we have one more system in this cluster to explore. Thanks for watching. See you next time. And endure. And enduring, grow strong.